I want to share with you my vision for Israel, and I'll try and do it in 3 minutes. We have the Arab Spring that started a couple of years ago, sort of morphed into a Muslim winter, and we're entering a new era of chaos, of ongoing chaos. It might take 10, 20, or probably more likely 50 years of this instability from Tunis to Damascus, from Tehran to Egypt, from Pakistan to Libya. The storm, and there's nothing we can do about this storm. Nothing we in Israel can do will affect what happens in Pakistan or Yemen, Turkey or Egypt. It's here to stay. Israel is a lighthouse in a storm. A lighthouse in a storm. A lighthouse has strong foundations. It's got to be strong, so we have strong connection to our land that goes back 3,800 years. We've got a powerful economy, a very good economy, which I'll talk about. And we've got perhaps the strongest military in the region, Tzal, the IDF. But a lighthouse is not just about having strong foundations. Any tower has strong foundations. A lighthouse projects light. And that's what Israel needs to be, and Israel is, both in terms of the way we govern ourselves, where women can drive, unlike neighboring countries. Anyone can protest, and everyone does. And it's a vibrant democracy with all the benefits and all the problems. And you can tell me about it. But we also need to project outward and do good. I'll tell you one story that will illustrate what I mean. I just came back from India about a month ago. Israel set up a dozen model farms, and I visited one of these model agriculture farms where we train every year at each of them roughly 20,000 Indian farmers, teach them advanced agriculture methodologies, and share with them technologies, and if we can sell some, all the better. So this Dr. Yadav, this Indian PhD, told me until 2 years ago, they produced 1 kilogram of cucumbers per 1 square meter per year. Using our methodologies, they're up to 10. That's what Israel's about. Multiplying tenfold the cucumber production in an Indian town, that's what Israel is about. The Jewish destiny is tikkun olam, fixing the world. Look at our history. From Avraham Avinu that we talked about, that was out to fix the world, through Moshe Rabbeinu, through Einstein, through Karl Marx. Some don't really work, but we're always out to try and change it. We're always about trying to make the world a better place. That's our raison d'etre. And that's what our economy needs to be about. So right now Israel is undergoing, and I'm trying to accelerate this, a transformation from just being a startup nation to being a lighthouse nation. And that's in 5 areas. Water technologies, alternative energy, food and agriculture, medical devices, and cybersecurity. All of these 5 areas are areas in which we excel, where we can do well, but we can also do good. Producing water in Africa, growing tomatoes in India, protecting America's cybersecurity, online banking. This is our new mission. This is what we're about. In this storm, we need to continue projecting light and doing good.
Back on the shtick, we're still with Mr. Marcus Mandie.
Good to be with you, Henry.
Yes, and what did you think of Mr. Naftali's talk?
I thought he was terrific. He's very dynamic. He's been raised in the US for a period of time, so his English is superb.
Mm-hmm.
And he spoke really well about Israel's economy and the innovation that's coming out of Israel.
And also the challenges.
The challenges, indeed.
Mm. And being a lighthouse, being a light upon the nations, which is really the most important thing, isn't it?
Absolutely. So the innovation that's coming out of Israel, it's not only for the benefit of Israel, it's for the benefit of mankind. So when we're talking about medical devices and health and medical instrumentation or water supplying to Africa or to other parts of
growing
the world.
Growing tomatoes in India.
Growing tomatoes. And you know, in fact, Henry, the cherry tomato
mm-hmm.
came from Israel, from the Hebrew University's commercialization arm, Yisum. They invented the cherry tomato.
Fantastic. And the Victorian state government at the actual table where we were sitting announced that they were giving a grant for innovation.
Absolutely. It's a very exciting initiative between the state of Victoria and the state of Israel. And what this involves is it's called the Visits Program or the Visits Scheme. And what it does is to encourage closer collaboration between Israeli companies and Victorian companies for innovation. So it can be different areas. It can be high tech, IT, might be agriculture. And the objective is to have, there's a number of different streams. The first one is to have trade missions from Victoria to Israel to go across and see what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
The Victorian government will help subsidise Victorian companies to go to different conferences.
And they're giving substantial grants.
And they're giving grants. So they just announced that they're going to be giving $50,000 for Victorian companies that can have an Israeli partner to have a proof of concept undertaken. And so they put in an application and they get this grant of up to $50,000. And then if that is proven and it's seen as successful, the next stage is what's called VizTech, which is a greater pool of money, which might be $250,000 or $200,000, which they can then apply for. So this is all a part of Victoria fostering greater collaboration with Israel and helping Victorian companies. And I think I should pay great credit to David Southwick, the member for Caulfield, who's put in a lot of time and effort to make this this reinvigorate the fund. And
well done, David.
And also Louise Asher, who's the minister.
Who announced it. And you've got a thing called the Young Business Forum, which is run by Barry Liberman and Romy Grace.
Well, Barry actually was the speaker of our last Young Business Forum event.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a committee which is about eight young business executives and entrepreneurs. Alon Kasuda is actually the chairperson. Romy's on the committee.
Yeah.
And they invited Barry to be the keynote speaker for the last Young Business Forum. So the Young Business Forum is part of the Australia Israel Chamber of Commerce. It's our young leadership division. We're starting an exciting mentoring program coming up.
There's the thing that we featured earlier in the year called the Eden Project, which was which took place at the Small Giants House, which is where Berry is related.
Exactly, and she spoke about social enterprise and making a difference.
Which is what we're trying to do. We're trying to auspice these people to be able to get a grant using their innovative ideas to get innovation really happening.
Absolutely, and innovation doesn't have to be in one particular area. It can cross across all boundaries in not-for-profits, profits, academic institutions, universities, business, across all boundaries.
It's all about business.
Absolutely.
And having fun. And Marcus, talking about business, we've got to leave this segment now. And we're going to head into the third segment now. We're going to do a dedication to the late Mr. Nelson Mandela, who whose funeral is actually today as we go to air. And also a dedication at the very end to the living icon, Leonard Cohen. So we're looking forward to that. And Marcus, Mandy, it's been a real pleasure to have you on the show.
Thanks very much for having me.
That's okay.
Thanks, Henry.
Pleased to have you. Well, I'll see you after the break.